Hello, boys and girls. We have with us today a genuine Indian chief of the Chippewa tribe in Michigan. His name is Little Elk in Chippewa Indian language, but in English he is called Mr. Eli Thomas. Little Elk was born in 1895, which makes him one of the oldest chiefs on his reservation. If at times the sound of his talking seems to fade, remember that Little Elk is a very old man, and sometimes he has difficulties in changing Chippewa language into English. Now let us listen very carefully to his true stories of life in the Indian tribes long ago. Then we will learn how to do the dances the same way they did them, around the campfires, under the stars. Hello, Mr. Thomas. What is your Indian name?
I go by the name of Little Elk.
How do you say Little Elk in Chippewa?
Mishamance.
How did you get the name Little Elk?
I got that from one person. He got so old, he gave that to me. And I'm proud of it, too.
Can you tell us how old you are?
I came to this world 1895.
Now, Little Elk, can you tell us about the corn grinders dance?
This corn grinding ceremony, that this year takes place in the fall, when the corn is ripened. They didn't put them into a crib or anything. They braid the corn, leave the husk on it, and braid that corn. Oh, you ought to see that, how it's done. It'd be worth something to know of our history of our people, how we take care of our winter provisions. Now this corn is hung on the maybe alongside the wigwam, and that's dry, nice and dry. Now after that's taken care of, the harvesting of that corn, and then we do about the same thing what we did on that there on the spring of the year, what I just said, the Grand March. Now we have this Grand March is every time we gather together, like maybe maple sugar time, we gather there, and then when the strawberries are just ripened, we gather together there, and then in midsummer we gather together, and then in the fall we have these gathers for that one reason. We thank the Mother Nature or the Great Spirit that done a great job of watering our corn and make them grow, and here we are, we're happy. And then we have this corn grinding dance. First, before we eat that corn, we have a ceremonial for it, and it go good.
Who does this dance? Only the men or just the women?
The women dance. They circle around, and this the one that's going to grind corn, maybe two women grind corn, and then they dance around that corn grinder, and she dances around there, and this one's from the east, she stays there, and then the dance goes on, and then the one that's going to be on the north, she stays there, standing, and then on the south, and then she stays there too. There are four ladies acting as the four winds. And then they go on, and the drum is beating. Then it goes on till the ladies are grinding corn. They begin to grind, put their corn in the into the mortar or in the corn grinder. They put a good handful of corn in there and begin to grind it, and keeping time with the tom-tom, same time. And then these women, they dance to the corn grinder, where these two ladies are grinding. They go out there, and then they bow, and then they go back. And then they dance around them. Maybe sometimes they go in one quarter. They go out there and stand. Then they go back into that place again, to that corn grinder, and then they bow again. And about four times they bow, and then the corn is just about ready to be presented to these four women that are going to present that into four to the Great Spirit, Mother Earth, and the four winds. So they do that. It's quite a sight to see that done.
After the corn is ground in the dance, what do the dancers do with it? Do they scatter it?
No, these two women, they put that corn into that empty dish and put it there, and the other one, these four women, they got their little corn in there. And then they get a pinch of that corn, and then they dance around that thing again. And when the north comes, when they all come to that same place, and then they throw that corn to the north, feeding nature. Then they dance over to this corner again, all dance at the same time. And then when they get through, and then they come in there and bow to that corn grinder and that corn. And then these ladies begin to dance around other way now, and then dance out.
Corn was very important to the Indians, wasn't it?
Corn is their living.
Now let us pretend that it is the month of the corn moon, and it is time to give thanks to the Great Spirit for our wonderful corn harvest.